Welcome to this new video series about FortiClient deployment on Windows 2016 standard server and on Windows 10 desktops. The primary reason of creating this video is to explain how Windows 10 remote client can SSL VPN into the domain and how it can be automatically deployed on the endpoints using FortiClient managed by the EMS server. What we're going to use here is then an Active Directory user group. I call it SSLVPN, and whoever is a member of that group will be able to deploy FortiClient and use the FortiClient to SSLVPN into the enterprise. There are two members of this group, Aaron Kohn and John Chen. The next step is to use group policy to make a few changes required to successfully deploy FortiClient. Let's just create a new group policy. And through that group policy, we can make a few changes in the system services and firewall inbound rules. I call this new group policy for the client installation policy and click on OK. And the next step is to assign our new security group, which I call SSLVPN, to this new group policy. I can remove authenticated users later, but let's just keep it as is. But let's just continue with the configuration. Fortinet publishes the Enterprise Management Server Administration Guide that lists all the requirements for successful FortiClient deployment on the endpoints. There are a few changes that we need to make on the endpoints. So let's just edit this group policy and go to Windows Services. And edit this service. Let's just start with a schedule that should be started automatically. The next service to change is the Windows installer that should be started manually. So define this policy settings, and from the default disabled, let's just change it to manual. And the last service is the remote registry, and we need to start it automatically on the endpoints. Click on OK to save the change. And then the next step is to enable two firewall rules. So let's go to Windows Firewall and Inbound Rules. So what we have to create is to enable File and Print Sharing SMB in and Remote Schedule Task Management RPC policy in to the desktops. So let's just create a new rule. It's a predefined service. So just we can search for File and Printer Sharing. Click on Next and select only what we need, which is the SMB in. And then click Next again. And then Finish. And just repeat the same step, right-click and enable Remote Schedule Task Management. Again, we only enable what we need, and that is the RPC service only. And click on Finish to save the change. So now our next step is to make sure that we only enable these two firewall policies when the clients are domain joined at the enterprise. We don't want those ports to be open on the desktops when they are in a private or a public network. So let's just edit the policy, go to advanced and enable domain only. And click on OK to save the change. Let's just verify these changes that we're going to deploy. And those are the three changes in the services and the two firewall inbound rules. The final step is to make sure our linked group policies are running in the correct order. So let's just move FortiClient to the top, so the default domain policy is not going to overwrite our changes. The next step is to check the client to make sure that we have all these changes successfully executed through the group policy. So we log in as aaron.com. And this is our Windows 10 desktop. And let's just have a look at the Windows services. Task schedule, it's already enabled and running. Start as automatic. The next service is the Windows installer. And it will be started manually. The final service is the remote registry. And the startup type is automatic. Finally, let's just have a look at our firewall policies. Try to find our file and print sharing. It's enabled on the domain only through the group policy. And the remote schedule task management, again, enabled on the domain only and also via the group policy. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.